Hi, I am Priyatos Jana, Assistant Professor of CSE at Mallabhum Institute of Technology, Bishnupur. Welcome to Fundamental Discussion on Graphics Processing Unit. At introduction, we can say Graphics Processing Unit, a specialized processor originally designed to accelerate graphics rendering. GPU can process many pieces of data simultaneously, making them useful for machine learning, video editing, and gaming applications. So, let's know what is GPU. It is a processor optimized for 2D, 3D graphics, video, visual computing, and display. GPU also capable of highly parallel multi-threaded multiprocessor optimized for visual computing. It provides real-time visual interaction with computed objects via graphics, images, and videos, etc. It serves as both programmable and graphics processors and a scalable parallel computing platform. Heterogeneous systems that we can say combinedly GPU with CPU. So here is the GPU evolution. At 1980s, the 18th century, no GPU, only PC used to VGA controller. In the 1990s, add more function into VGA controller. Around 1997, 3D acceleration functions like hardware for triangle setup and rasterization, texture mapping, shading, etc. So in 2000, a single chip graphics processor, here is the beginning of GPU talk. 2005, massively parallel programmable processors. In 2007 onwards, compute unified device architecture. So have a look on the fundamentally different design philosophies of CPU and the GPU. We can say GPU system architecture and GPU processing is highly data parallel. Means GPUs are highly multi-threaded, use thread switching to hide memory latency. We can say less reliance on multi-level caches, and graphics memory is wide and high bandwidth. Trend toward general purpose GPUs. So here, heterogeneous GPU or CPU systems, CPU for sequential code and GPU for parallel code. Now, programming languages or API, application programming interfaces. So here in GPU, that is DirectX, OpenGL, C for graphics, high level shader language, that is HLSL, and the compute unified device architecture. So here is the basic unified GPU architecture. Input assembler, vertex shader to geometry shader, and then geometry shader to the setup and rasterizer, then pixel shader, it goes to raster operations or output manager. So this is the unified processor array. So it is the graphics logical pipeline, input, assembler, vertex shader, geometry shader, setup and rasterizer, pixel shader, and finally it reaches to the output merger, or we can say raster operations. And GPU graphic trends. OpenGL usually an open standard for 3D programming. DirectX basically a series of Microsoft multimedia programming interfaces. And new GPU are being developed every 12 to 18 months. New idea of visual computing, heterogeneous system, that is CPU plus GPU, GPU computing, GPU unifies graphics and computing, and the GPU visual computing application. These are OpenGL and DirectX. Now CPU plus GPU is a heterogeneous system. GPU will not perform well on tasks on which CPUs are designed to perform well. For program that have one or very few threads, CPU with lower operation latencies can achieve much higher performance than GPU. When a program has a large number of threads, GPU with higher execution throughput can achieve much higher performance than CPUs. Many applications use both CPUs and GPUs, executing the sequential parts on the CPU and numerically intensive parts of the GPU. So this is all about fundamental of GPU. Thank you.